All right, everybody. Good day and welcome. Squad League here. We've got some awesome matches this weekend. This is our first one this weekend. First match up, we have 303rd versus White Fox on OP First Light here. We're just getting set to go. Almost ready here. We're going to be going at 152. Today, broadcasting, we have Doc East and I.
What's up?
Hey, Doc. Thanks for joining us. Dr. Biggs is also on there.
Going on.
And we've got our staff on. We've got Oakley and IBK helping us with the server, managing all of our stuff. And, yeah, we're excited to be here. We've got awesome quarterfinals ready for you guys this weekend. And we're just 30 seconds here, so let me get this queued up for these guys.
Also like to welcome our good friend, known him for a long time, Matt Lightfoot, who worked on Arma 3 for quite some time, works on Star Citizen a little bit, really loves Squad, and wanting to do this with us too as well. So welcome, Matt.
Howdy.
Howdy. All right. Here we go.
Here we go. Sending them away. So we'll be following the 303rd for the first round here. And then we'll switch it up and follow White Fox for that second round there. But we're playing on OP First Light. Been seeing a lot of this map. And like I said earlier, we're in quarterfinals now. So we've got 8 clans playing this weekend. 4 on Saturday, 4 on Sunday. Almost 150 players that are playing in Squad League events this weekend, and we're going to get quarterfinals out of the way in one weekend. So it's going to be a lot of streaming, a lot of awesome action for Squad, and we're happy to bring it to you guys. So here we are following 303rd. Let me pull up the map here.
And just FYI, I am on White Fox's side so that I can get the ticket counts and listen on their commander comms, which is totally silent. So I'm not sure if they're going the TeamSpeak route or anything like that, but either way, I'm not hearing anything on this side.
Roger that.
Same thing over here as well. I think we've kind of hashed out their initial plan. As soon as they're taking contact, we'll probably start hearing some commander comms.
Yeah.
Trying to get local to them to see if I got anything there, and I'm not hearing any local chatter either. You know, everybody at the very beginning of these matches is all hyped up, playing music on the way, talking smack, all that stuff, but these dudes are business oriented right now.
Yeah, I'm gonna put our fob up in Bravo 9.
Call out already on the 303rd side for a fob in Bravo 9. Banshee on the radio there. That's him.
Must be contacts right in the center of the map again.
Yep.
Yeah, I was gonna say, Matt, or Doc Charlie East, we're seeing definitely the White Fox start rolling down that center map vein right now.
Absolutely.
And another reminder, we will be calling this map at 100 tickets for both rounds. So 300 tickets up there. We'll be calling the match down at 100 tickets.
All right, about to have first contact.
All right, guys, we have people coming up already.
About to be a lot of contact on the east side of storage site. They're both coming on that east side right now.
White Fox taking the first couple kills.
I think I managed to get one of the 303rd's medics as well.
Alright, let me know if they get around you. I can push guys that way. How you doing up there, Clerky?
White Fox locking down that center ridgeline. Okay, we've got guys inside. Holding that ridgeline just to the east of storage right now. That's really going to be detrimental in the long run if they don't. 303rd doesn't push them off of that.
I hear them inside the fucking building.
Yep.
You guys getting any commander comms yet?
A little bit.
Yeah, a little bit about fob placement.
Alright, you got White Fox coming on the west side of storage, but there's a big movement by 303rd about to come in on the other side, on the west side of storage on these guys. So definitely see how this plays out in a second, but White Fox definitely inside storage, trying to get a grip on it.
Absolutely. We'll see if 303rd here coming from the southwest down here and kind of shift them off of there, but White Fox has a solid hold on storage right now. You gotta get squad
and
half.
As last week proved, once you get a good grip on storage, okay, it's pretty hard to get back up.
Definitely.
Or pretty hard to take, rather.
They're calling for some more help on the objective.
I take it out in the west, are they about to place a fob? Banshee? Screw. There's three of them running around out there.
Yes. They dropped one actually southwest of Nilrim. Southwest of the village.
We're getting to the south side of storage to hold a flank.
I assume it's not going to be long before White Fox has storage.
No, they should have it here any second.
Something else to keep in mind. Remember this for all of us watching the match that there are some exploits in this map right now. If you get inside that big water barrel or drum or whatever and you stand behind the poles, you could shoot out, but you can't be shot. In a castle, there's kind of the same thing where you could shoot out of the mesh inside castle, but you can't be shot back in. So if we see that happening, we need to jump on the local VoIP and say to get away from that, that there's an exploit, just so that it's not being abused.
We're pushing up now to try to take it. If you can hold that right side.
Alright.
So you see now, those 303 guys are just to the west of storage. They engaged the White Fox guys in storage, and so they've actually rotated and shifted some of their guys from their north. So they've got an enemy squad up there trying to push them out and put pressure on them to take that hilltop back on the west side. That's going to be smart for 303 for White Fox, pushing them off right there and keeping them from having an avenue approach into actual storage itself.
Got Banshee starting to come down there on the west side of it with that bullet magnet.
We took the casualties. We're trying to reassess our line.
Go ahead, Matt.
Further east,
yeah,
we're getting flanked.
We're going to push up now. We're getting contacts by this container.
All right, make sure you're marking enemy positions on the map.
So they just capped. White Fox just capped storage.
West warehouse is clear.
You look at it too. A bunch of them are starting to leave now. They're about to leave it open a little bit.
White
except
Fox,
that
yeah.
One guy. They've got one guy acting likely as a feeler.
Yep. Yeah, they're aware of that squad. Well, they were there. Looks like White Fox wiped them. You see how they pulled off the actual cap, White Fox? So that was very smart for them.
Be discovered.
Yeah. That was very smart for them to get them on top of the ridgeline with them and push them off. You don't want to engage an enemy squad on top of a hill when you're below them. You know, you really want to get, if you can, you really want to get up on top of the hill with them and engage them
it's
on their
equal
level.
Footing.
Exactly. And that's exactly what White Fox did and pushed them up that western hill.
White Fox is marking all over their map. From what I can tell, it looks like one squad might be using the kind of more of the sword in the ground look. The other guys are using the arrows, kind of marking their territory all over the center of the map.
Pretty good little front going on right now. It's the same way with 303. They're placing pretty accurate markings. There seems to be a good solid line here as opposed to last week's matches. At the moment.
Still no commander comms, so I'm going to go with the idea that they're using...
Speak. Do you want us to jump on the defense, guys?
Yeah, getting intermittent comms here on the 303rd side.
Yeah, put half your squad on the defense.
Mostly just talking tactics, fob locations, stuff like that.
Yep. Got three White Fox guys kicking out to the west out here.
We're gonna take over defense, guys.
That's all one right. Of two things. That's either a ninja fob squad, or they're a ninja cap squad trying to sneak around the side.
Looks like they're waiting on each other. I think they're trying to... They could be... No, I don't know if they're trying to place a fob themselves.
They might be.
They have one fob right now, and it's northeast of storage a little bit.
Right. The two main avenues approach on storage is the west and east hills working your way in. Trying to run across the south side, it's possible, but you have all that open fields and stuff you got to cross, and that's obviously pretty dangerous. But if you control that western hill and that eastern hill, those are the two main avenues of approach into storage. You control those, you control that objective pretty well, and that's what White Fox has been doing so far. 303rd's been working their way in and scared them a little bit, but they masked precisely where 303rd was trying to move.
266 they, tickets left here for 303rd. How are we looking on?
290.
Okay.
Yep.
White Fox taking a little bit of an edge there. 303rd backed up now to the village. They've got some guys skirmishing out there by storage, but for the most part, on the western side of the map here, push back to the storage tanks as well as all the way back to village as well. They've got that fob there on the west.
Who, 303rd does?
Yeah, it's kind of down there to the south, just southwest of the village.
Yep.
See a couple of them spawning in down there, and they're pushing out on the western flank, coming into storage from that side. The Bash Squad 1 in the hills there. Go ahead, Doc.
So squad coming in from the south, like I was saying. Pretty difficult for them to get in there, because all White Fox has to do, really, is if they control that western eastern hill, they just move a little bit further south, and they whoever comes in from that south end, that's a silo, or whatever you want to call it, oil tank, they pretty much have no cover, and they'll just get caught in a crossfire right there.
Looks like Banshee out in the southwest is trying to lead a pretty good sweeping movement into the northern side. I assume they're going to sort of head north storage. And work up the west side of storage.
Yeah, we're trying to get in there. We're taking contact.
The force is pretty good. This is a very like backwards and forwards battle. Like, nobody
very well balanced between those two teams.
We can get a little bit push on this together as a group.
I love we're seeing the two squads out to the west trying to outmaneuver each other. You know, we saw the team three earlier trying to take the western hill. Now we're seeing the entire 303rd squad with Banshee move around further to the west, maneuver those guys off the hill.
Yeah, absolutely. Like I said, they're trying to take that western hill. It's a very, very viable entrance, like I said, between the western and eastern hills. You control that hill. And you have enough pressure on that hill to push down into storage, you can, more often than not, get in there and at least get a foothold.
So it seems like White Fox is doing a pretty decent job of... Those guys in the west are up on that hill so they can detect that rather than just sitting in the building on the west side of storage. So they're likely to detect that Banshee movement before they even start getting in there.
Absolutely. Yeah, we're that's one of the main tenets, I believe, of a squad, as far as like capping and attacking and defending objectives. Actually being off those objectives will almost always is actually more important than actually being on the cap itself. Having people in there, obviously, to cap it, you know, you have to have that. But actually being off those objectives and controlling key terrain around those objectives that facilitate movement into the objective to begin with, you control those. You can control the objective, and that's what White Fox is doing right now.
That's actually the core tenet of defense in depth, that you can engage the enemy away from an objective, the more ground you have that you can fall back and draw them into the trap.
Absolutely. Yeah, you don't want to sit, you know, all of you guys in one position, especially, you know, you want to hug the objective, so to speak. So, like I said, Matt was saying, you know, basing yourself off an objective is more important, actually, than hugging the objective itself.
Yeah, keep them busy at our
defense. You know, there's circumstances sometimes where you're going to have to do that. You know, Roger there's that. A big push happening. You need to get as many people in the cap itself to stop them from capping to begin with. You know, you're going to have to rush as many people in there. But, So 303rd making that western move right now.
Ooh, it seems that's just been detected.
Yep.
Yep, there it goes.
Two down right away.
It also looks like milk is going to go bad.
White Fox is starting to dedicate a bunch of resources going out there to the west to meet that head on.
That might be what you need. Sometimes you can literally get away with that. Instead of having an entire squad out there, you come in from a very threatening position, like where 303rd is out to the west right now, and you can literally have two or three guys out there just make a bunch of noise and make it seem like there's an entire enemy squad there for the enemy to dedicate, you know, extra resources to stop that push. So,
well, 303rd has three guys up out in that west.
Right. But what I'm saying is, like, using people almost like a distraction, almost a diversion, for so to speak. You know, making yourself seem like you're larger than you are in a dangerous position, as 303rd could be in that position.
Sure.
You know, would make White Fox think, oh, crap, you know, they're pushing us really hard from this position where they can get onto us. You know, we're going to have to mass more of our guys, take some from one spot and put them there, you know, therefore weakening that other spot. So, like out east, if 303rd were to mass over there and rush in, they would get into storage pretty damn quickly.
Hey, so is squad we've got squad 2 heading down into the southwest. Are they pretty near their fob now? Looks like they're about to find out.
Yeah, they're getting really close.
I assume they're going to try to take that out. What tickets
were
285?
229 here. They're I think looking to drop their own. But in the meantime while they do that, they're probably going to discover this one.
I was going to say they're probably going to find that out.
Yeah, a little three-man squad like that. Nathan, it's the only purpose they have.
No, it's Rain is their squad lead for 2.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, definitely with them being 3 of them total, they're likely going to be placing a fob. But if they run into that other one, but to see what this reaction from these 303 guys at Nilrim, you know, 303 seems to be trying to ensure that they don't lose Nilrim, but White Fox isn't even trying to push Nilrim.
To attack storage with you. The defense flag is...
Look at the spacing out in the east of White Fox. Trying to detect any movements out there from 303rd.
As they did in the previous game.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Where they're at right now is a very key position where you see... I think where Rusty is looking right now, it might be center of the map, basically the center ridge line, invisible. Or visible, I'm sorry. KL, CPAC, Azul. Where they're at right there is a very key position.
Oh.
They find that fob?
They found the fob. People just start spawning in on the fob, so...
Enemies camping.
Yep, here comes 303rd reacting now. Some of the guys from Nilrim, you've got
they're
Fire digging. Potato and Meetu.
Right, they're digging their fob?
Just called out the commander tent. Comes as well. It looks like 303rd are starting to react with Fire Protector Mitsu orientating to the southwest now.
So 303 is going to probably be kind of panicking a little bit, trying to get the fob up. Yep, there's Banshee. Losing the fob.
Your one shovel on it.
Fobs are very, very, very valuable. You know, as soon as you see that thing start flipping to red, you need to devote an entire squad to turn and get that thing back up. Like Mitsu's about to clear it here in a second. Looks like he's throwing a frag grenade. I should get it. Oh, he overshot. Not going to be enough. There's one. Two.
Ooh.
Clutch. Gets him.
Good shot.
Mitsu with the fob clear. So now 303 is going to start thinking about digging this fob up and moving it since they have a good lock on where it's at. But that's going to slow down the momentum of 303rd. You know, whatever push they had going on, they had to divert some of their attention back there.
Hey, I'm
going to
move this fob.
Yep, there it goes. I'm going to move the fob.
Good call.
Seems now that WF as well are starting to reinforce the base again, so the ensuing 303rd attack could just fall flat on its face.
Yeah, they keep trying to push to the south down there.
I see they held off their fob, correct?
And you can see over here as well, like a small little fight in the squad 3 rally, Rusty. The center of the map here.
We are able to push up.
Yeah, I'm gonna
bridge,
zoom over there now.
Not able to really do anything going in east because they keep.
Notice that kill to death ratio.
Basically,
you pulled that up. 55 kills, 22 deaths.
Yeah, 223 tickets too here for the 303.
Almost a 2-to-1 ratio.
Can hear them on commander comms talking about not being able to push in from the east. That the that center ridge line is completely controlled by White Fox and it's preventing them from pushing in on that eastern side.
Absolutely. It's that goes to show, you know, you control that center ridge line and you control where they're at right now in White Fox. You have a very good lock of, you know, the US team pushing out of Maine and into storage from that east side.
Well, let's see if those guys in the southwest on 303rd, if they try to make a push at least up through the south or, you know, the west side. But, you know, White Fox is doing a really good job of having people on that east and west side trying to make sure they detect. No, the movement.
Copy.
303rd is he blew that fob down south. They just kicked it out a little bit further to the west from where the old position was.
So they tore it down on their own then to move that?
Yes. But then you see Rain and his little fob hunting squad. They've kicked back out again. They're gonna start looking again. They know they've got to place one. So those 10 tickets, very, very important.
We're at 278 here, by the way.
217.
Yeah, you wonder what Banshee and their crew out there are doing. Is there any commander comms on that, alluding to what they're trying to do out there?
Out to the west? Not really, no. Unless they keep trying to take that western hillside.
I don't know if that's a big sweeping movement. There's definitely some firing about to go on out there in that the southwest.
Yeah.
Where are you Rain's covering that right now, Rusty?
About to go down. Contacts in the defense flag any second.
We're gonna hold it. No, Rusty's dealing with streaming issues.
Like Bash's squad moving further out to the north along that ridge line. If they can set up a good base of fire baseline on that ridge, they could take this from the east instead of the west that you keep that they keep getting hammered back on.
Absolutely. You kind of want to stay on the south side of that that center ridge line and push yourself a little bit further to the west as you go into storage. You know, obviously that's going to open up you to rounds coming from storage, because the center ridge line almost acts like a T, with the top of the T facing towards storage. So people on storage can easily just run up onto that center ridge line right there and have pretty significant cover concealment shooting you to the east as you run up that ridge. So you kind of be aware, you have to kind of be cognizant of that as you push that center ridge line towards storage. You can kind of defeat that by getting in as close as you can, but as long as you keep that pressure up, you should be able to get in there. The south side of storage looks like they're pulling back towards Nilram right now. I think they're waiting for the west and east squads to kind of get a foothold to get inside the objective and get closer before they feel comfortable enough to push out of the defense. That's pretty smart. You always want to have some kind of sensor back there, and in case something does happen, you might have to devote half a squad, or, you know, depending on the pressure, an entire squad to defend that objective safely. So you've got like Fire Potato, Clerky squad is actually down here on the defense. Banshee squad is out to the west. And Bashes is out to the east. Looking like they're slowly kicking their way out to the east, but I know, judging by the flow
Bareback.
And where White Fox has been coming from, they've got a fob somewhere to the northeast of storage. Definitely an attrition round, not so much an objectives round.
So just under, just over 200 tickets left for the 303rd. We will be calling the match down at 100 tickets. Running on AAS for OP First Light here.
So, you can see now, that southern squad comes off of Nilram. You know, sometimes you gotta take gambles. Sometimes you have to push away from an objective, you know, and time things correctly, but
right.
Usually that kind of stuff pulls off, and you end up steamrolling the other team. So those guys on Nilram, you know, they don't know it, but you can see how undefended storage is right now.
Right. Yeah, that's
the 303rd squad on Nilram, they could push north right now and easily cap that point before White Fox can do anything about it.
Right. White Fox really focusing on the sides of their objectives. Like we said, that middle elevated position in the middle of the map there in the forest. Been controlling that for most of the round, keeping the 303rd from pushing it on the eastern side, as well as controlling the forest to the west, which is where the 303rd has moved their fob. But, like you said, leaving that objective completely open.
Yeah, squad 2, there are the guys coming in from your
good push by 303rd in the south.
Yep.
Rusty, did you get the streaming stuff sorted?
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, it did. Sorry. Yeah.
Anyone else getting static on someone's mic?
Yeah, I'm getting that too.
That entire area.
The joys of forging a new path with streaming and all this stuff with these matches, you know, it's
well,
never...
You know, when
or
you're
OBS,
live,
rather.
When you're live streaming, it's like, oh, the stream's down, I'll just change the setting and restart it. But when it's a 15-minute delay, you then lose all of that footage and have to, you know, you
right,
lose that 15 minutes.
Down.
That's the issue.
West side. I'm gonna move east to.
Yeah,
village.
It's difficult, and then it's difficult to communicate to the Twitch chat. North from you know.
Yeah, it's not fun. To keep
while we're trying to cover, I don't have two monitors, so I can't really do that myself, at least until I get to Korea.
Well, I'll do monitors, so, you know, if you guys get anything, I can have communicate that.
Copy.
Should be up in 500 seconds. If that doesn't work, then we're having some serious issues.
White Fox sure is doing a very good job of holding off on storage.
Absolutely. They're holding those key terrain positions.
Right.
Yeah, man. Honestly, guys,
okay.
Just call
303rd has a lot of guys dedicated down there to Nilgrim Village, and we're about to lose this. You know, Doc, would you start trying to dedicate some of those forces to make a real push on it, or towards storage from Nilgrim? If you look, the vast majority of the 303rd players are concentrated in the south.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, do you start making a huge push?
Sounds good.
A concentrated push at that.
They're still bleeding us. They have storage.
You can. They're calling for a defense right now. 303rd is.
Kills, guys.
They're trying to turn this around as far as getting more kills. But you could. I mean, that's all situation dependent.
When you get shot.
No, and seeing it from this perspective, it's really easy to say if you can or not. But kind of got to feel. You got to kind of make a decision based on how the fight is feeling at the time.
But still,
so they can't get in through the east, and they can't get in through the west, and they keep getting chewed up as they go into the south. So you know, maybe it is a good idea to fall back and wait for them to attack and then counterattack once they throw themselves at you.
Sure,
that's actually a very good tactic as far as capping an objective. You know, if you're sneaky enough and you have one squad and that's all you have, and you have, like, you've overextended yourself, say, as a squad leader and running a squad, and you've capped an objective, and especially, you know, like towards your last objective, and so all of a sudden the entire enemy team is basically massing on you to take that flag back.
Since you guys are already on the west,
sometimes all it takes is pulling your guys out of there for a second, getting off a little ways back, dropping another rally point, giving it a second, making them think they capped it, and as they're looking around, getting their winded up, clearing the whatever compound or whatever you're at, you just counterattack back in there with the grenades and rush it back in, and more often than not, you can catch them by surprise and take an objective back.
Seems like 303rd has. Their push, but make sure pay attention out there in the southwest, Rusty. You got a little ninja squad trying to come in the southern part of Nilgrim, so.
Okay, yeah, I see them.
I think that's Rain squad out there.
Yep.
Squad 2.
You can see the positions they're taking, too.
You guys need help.
You can zoom in and see that.
If you need it.
303rd's got a squad just to the north of Nilgrim. They also got their squad out to the east, holding that east ridgeline, and then that squad out to the west. And you can see how they've got, like, two people in the cap. They're probably going to leave one person there, and that's it. That's another fine example of, you know, defending key avenues of approach or terrain.
Hit those two squads, see each other. Squad
yep.
two on White
yep,
Fox and
the
them,
west.
Where they just go right on by each other. You know, this would be one of those moments that we talked about last week. Does the squad 2 on White Fox, do they choose to engage those guys, letting them know that they're there, or just let those guys keep pushing up?
That's a judgment call. I mean, it depends on the goal you're looking for. At this point, you know, you being with your sitting from the White Fox perspective, pushing a team back this far, you're going to assume that they're going to be hugging the objective. So you can try to sneak in there and cap underneath their noses, but you're going to have to expect that there's going to be an enemy there. I mean, it would definitely catch them by surprise if they went down south and just went straight for the cap, killed no need to hate in there and started capping.
Sure. Here it comes right now. Rain squad's about to rain down on Mitsu and those guys. Rimsy.
Oh, wow.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, looks like they just committed.
Yep, they're clerking
and
went down.
Last one.
Yep.
Oh,
yeah, X-Bay went down too.
Big wipe. Big wipe
there.
165 tickets. Now
or 260.
260, okay. Starting to open it up, certainly, here. Yeah, good wipe from White Fox there, being able to have situational awareness of, you know, checking those surroundings, even 50 meters out. You know, are we alone out here? Stuff like that. So, very...
I don't know if you're noticing this for, you know, the audience that might not know, the upside-down triangles are the downed players, and a lot of upside-down triangles right now. 303rd not giving up. I think they're aware that their ticket counts are down, and they're probably not as apt to give up at this point.
159 for tickets.
So we're about 100 ticket difference right now.
That's a pretty curious little move right now. That their third squad just got wiped out to the west. You see Rain's squad. You see him pull off of those guys right away. Yeah, they probably did that one to get their wounded up, even though it looks like there's only four of them left.
And which you wonder...
Probably to drop a rally. Or two, to pull away from there, knowing the enemy's going to mass in that objective.
Are they out
position.
There to prevent movement, or... It doesn't look
third?
Like they're actually trying to move into Nilrim.
They might be. They're probably going to drop a fob out there, and they're probably looking for an enemy fob at the same time.
Nah, but
they've got a couple people inside, inside Nilrim right now for White Fox.
Got it. It's just textbook guerrilla tactics. They saw a target of opportunity, they took it, now they're bugging out. And I think that's one of the things that we've seen from White Fox most of the game, that whenever they've had one of their scouts take contact, they've been able to orientate towards that contact really quickly, really effectively, which brought them back away from the compound earlier.
Right.
And it looks like Rain Squad, you know, they wiped that squad because they totally got the drop on them.
You want to move to a building?
Absolutely, right. And you know what it does too from Nilrim, so anyone from 303rd that's in Nilrim, you know, they almost have to watch in a 360 degree,
on our south too.
You know, area around Nilrim itself, rather than just, oh, they could be coming from the north, well, crap, I mean, you got these guys coming up the southwest, you got the north, northwest, you got some guys out there in the northeast a little bit, so...
Right.
Definitely have to watch all the angles.
Yep. A lot of action going on in the village here. Nilrim.
They've actually hit right at you.
White Fox being very aggressive, taking building by building now. Using the windows to shoot out from. Very aware of their cover here. They caught an entire 303rd squad trying to bandage here. Took them down.
Got to... That squad down the south, Rain Squad down here. I think they know... 303 knows that they're maneuvering down there. But definitely utilizing one of those core tenets of squad, man, is communication and maneuvering is probably two of the most important ones, I believe. You've got all this terrain, you might as well maneuver and use it. You know?
I mean, they're just trapping the 303 defenders in an all-round assault.
Absolutely.
And even if they threw all of those guys in one direction, it's far more difficult to defend in 360-degree arc, just because of all the crossfire and such. And it looks like they're just going to be caught in the absolute grinder here now.
Absolutely.
East side is getting pushed in hard.
Like the squad leader from White Fox is just on open mic on squad comms and he's just typing. Oh, what it is he's doing right now. Yeah, it might be him playing, hitting the keyboard, but...
Yes, you mechanical keyboards.
Break off squad just to check off at the attack real quick.
Alright, sounds good.
Roger that.
.137.
255. They're definitely surrounding Nilrim pretty damn well now.
Yeah, they've got them
those medics
from all sides there.
303rd. They got a tough job right now trying to keep these guys up.
Definitely.
So what would be a move to get out of this situation? Obviously, you have to sit back and defend your flag, but you know, this if they're bleeding personnel at this rate, what do? Do you try to punch forward? Do you try to hit them at the flanks?
It's pretty difficult There's almost a point of no return with tickets, and you can do it. You can definitely do it with kills. It's unlikely and difficult to do to come back with kills. But as far as pushing out of this objective, you know, trying to kick guys out to the east and southwest, you know, and try to get the control of your flanks and get control of those hills around you, and then push back out. That's what you got to do. And then it comes down to, you know, taking your squad, you know, getting everybody to, you know, stop for a second. Consolidate, think about what you're doing, especially as a squad leader, and rallying your guys and pushing your guys systematically out to the east and west. So, especially using terrain and concealment to facilitate that. Because otherwise they're just going to keep enveloping you like they've been doing in the east and west sides.
Right.
Hey, Rusty, I've got people that ping me in the background. Just we'll take a moment to do this, but... Does streaming to YouTube simultaneously have any effect on the Twitch streaming?
No. Unless unless the
explain
service...
Explain to these people why that are listening, why that this is not the case.
Well, so, it is the case right now because the service that we use is what is causing the Twitch stream to crash. But
talking about OBS?
No, it's a secondary source.
Okay.
And basically, I didn't think it would do it again because I tested it extensively, but it ended up doing the same thing. In the time that my delay is uploading, it will scramble the IP, or I'm sorry, the stream key. So then when OBS goes to try to write that to the stream, it's a different key, and it ends up not being able to stream. And like I said, since you have that 15-minute delay, you have to stop, lose the footage, find out what's wrong, and then start it over again. So it's a 30-minute process if you mess something up or if something messes
up.
Yeah,
it's always unfortunate, you know, especially when you want to get a really good stream and coverage, and last week went so well.
Yeah,
you know, it's always a...
You definitely have ups and downs, for sure.
Looks like White Fox took a pretty good wipe and then had to spawn at that fob just north of storage.
This is where the little lull that 303 is seeing right now. This is where you need to think like, oh hey, they're not pushing us as hard as they were a second ago. This might be our window. So that's something you got to be aware of. You know, every time you're attacking or defending an objective, especially defending, when that pressure starts to let up a little bit, you got a little bit of breathing room, and if you don't take advantage of that, you might miss that opportunity.
IBK just informed us we're live on Twitch.
Yeah. Yeah, like we've said in posts before, we're still alpha, we're still figuring things out. We definitely put OBS through its paces. I think we're using every single feature that we can get out of that program.
We're running up to the academy.
So I don't blame it for not working completely well, because we are putting it up against the boundaries of what it's capable of doing.
Also, too, in these situations, it's kind of far off in the game now, but another thing you can do when you get kind of capped back into in a flag like this, almost like Nilrim, if it's early in the game and you've got enough tickets to spare, and even still, regardless, kicking out a small squad and then having people defend as hard as they can on that defend and looping them around and taking the next flag up can sometimes take the pressure off that flag you're being hit on so hard. It's going to be even more hairy for the defenders, obviously, But usually in these situations, especially in public situations too, on public servers, when you see a last flag like this down here, when it last flag, but towards the end, you're going to see the attacking team start to pour as many guys on there as they can, leaving very little defenders.
Right.
Yeah.
So that would be, and like these two guys on the cap right now, a small squad of maybe four guys, maybe five guys, can easily get in there and start capping enough to scare them and either bring pressure off of the defense flag, giving your guys in the defense time to start pushing out, or
what's the
that could be a reversal.
What's tick count over there?
111.
111. So we're 245. I mean, so let's analyze real quick. What do we think that the keys to victory for White Fox? I think it was their ability in the beginning to hold that west and east hill line
definitely.
By storage.
Yeah,
they definitely did a really good job of preventing through a third from coming in at any of those points.
Definitely, that's the key. You control those western and eastern hills. You can control them coming out of their main from the east. You can control them in the hills of the west, and then you can control them if they try to come in from the south, because you can shoot them and get them in a nasty crossfire right there. I'm gonna go in this way. So you control the center line,
everyone
the eastern line,
and just wait
in the western.
Just trying to get as many kills as possible. Just lay down. Literally.
108 tickets left, so we will be calling down at 100.
Clark, where are you, man? Are you in the building?
Yeah.
I did a retard walk all over the town.
Very valiant defense from through a third, and White Fox ball through a third was pressing him pretty good in the beginning there. And White Fox has just been slowly grinding him back.
Yeah, they've held that Nilrim really well, but just you know, at that stage, it's not just kills and deaths back and forth, nail rim now.
Yep, 4 tickets.
What kind of break are we going to take after this, Rusty? 10-minute?
Yeah, we can do a 10-minute break.
Copy.
Get these teams switched up. Interesting to see if they're able to, you know, from a different side of the map, maybe they might have a different tactic. Some teams
We have yet to see. I don't think we've seen the split map yet, have we? Every team that's won has won both matches. Is that correct?
Yeah, I think so.
Hopefully we'll see if 303rd is the first to turn that. So everyone else knows how we sort it. If 303rd won the next round, whoever had the most tickets at the end is the tiebreaker.
One ticket. There it is.
I just saw Grimsy.
All right, so there we see 303rd losing the first match. They still got one more round here. They can come back and win, but they will have to have one hell of a match here, as a tie would go to tickets. So we're going to get reset here. We're going to get these teams switched up. We will be taking a 10-minute break here. Let these guys get switched up, talk about tactics, get in their groups and their squads, and get ready to go. Plot. And we will be back in 10. Thanks for sticking with us.